perhaps an excuse which may have done it. We couldn't see it from here. We didn't hear anything from here. And we're at the pool itself. But Miguel Duran Navia of Spain is back.
Oh, I wonder how his adrenaline is right now. His heart would be in his mouth.
And the other thing, of course, is how the others respond to this. They cannot be influenced by it. Back on the blocks now. Perfect start this time. Well, we'll see how this affects, particularly lane 7. Duran Navia, he was in tears a moment ago. It must have affected him mentally, as we see Al-Kamash of Egypt and Akram of Egypt, the two in lanes 4 and 5. Al-Kamash in lane 5 is leading. It's Mika over from the Czech Republic on the far side. Matt Hutchins of New Zealand, who trains out of the States, is in 2. Ibsen of Denmark is in 3. And it's the two Egyptians touching first. And the Spaniard, who left the blocks early, looked to be disqualified, but not, is in lane 3 and in third place. And lane 7 and in third place.
Marwan Al-Kamash is a beautiful technician. He's leading at the moment, one of two Egyptian swimmers, as John said. Nice high elbows, very smooth in the water, and in fact going out so fast that he is well and truly ahead of the world record pace.
This is an extraordinary first 100 from Al-Kamash. Next to him, Akram. Akram trains. In the States, he was fourth in the 1500 meters at the World Championship, so a long distance man, but they all above the 400. It gives them a taste in the pool as well, if they plan swimming the open water as well. But the Egyptians, Al-Kamash and Akram, across the top of the pool, we can see Mika and then Hutchins, and alongside of him, Ibsen of Denmark.
World records held by Paul Biedermann. It's 340.07 during the super suit era, so the second half of that world record swim by Paul Biedermann was very fast. So now they're coming back to the field a little bit. And
Al-Kamash.
He's having a look underwater, Al-Kamash, interestingly.
Yeah. What do you mean by that?
So he's breathing away from his teammate, but when he puts his face back in, his eyes are diverting off to his teammate to see where he is. So now he has some company.
Now he knows he's breathing, you can see, to his right, so he's looking at his teammate, who in turn is looking backwards. So they're viewing each other, seeing the goggles of each other alongside of them. They know each other's style and spent a bit of time together, these two. And this is interesting, isn't it? Not often you talk about Egypt being dominant in a heat of the 400 meters freestyle. But it's encouraging that they are. Their distance swimming has improved. With outside influences, it's really good. In lane 4, Akram is leading. Al-Kamash is second.
Akram's been to 2 world championships previously. His first Olympic Games. First Olympic Games for Marwan Al-Kamash as well. So he's just losing a little bit of contact with Akram. Maybe the speed of the first 100 metres is going to take its toll in the second half of the race. We're getting into the 300 metre mark now. And it's still Akram, probably not as good technically underwater on the turns that we've seen some of the swimmers already and that we will see in later heats.
It's about time they started to make their moves now. We noticed Ibsen, who's just on the right of our screen now, was looking to move forward. Gleisner of Denmark, we haven't talked about him much, but Ibsen in lane 3, and look at Hutchins also in lane 2, and Mika of the Czech Republic, and they come to the wall and touch now, and it's Al-Kamash, Akram and Ibsen, but there's not much between them all now, as that lead the Egyptians had is starting to be eaten away.
Very close now, and Al-Kamash picks it back up again. He's found something in reserve. The big 6-speed kick is going, still having a very nice long stroke, breathing away from the field.
And pressed too by Hutchins of New Zealand, this 21-year-old who trains out of the University of Wisconsin. He's up in lane 2. He's starting to close the gap on the leaders and moves into second place at the finish. Al-Kamash wins it. Hutchins second, Ibsen third. And so while the two Egyptians led throughout, it was a fast start for them. Al-Kamash was able to hold at 347.43. Ibsen of Denmark at 348.31. Inside his personal best, Eddie, as well. Al-Kamash wins, he 4.